Recently, the U.S. Army has selected the Enhanced Vertical Takeoff and Landing Unmanned Aerial Vehicle, VBAT, developed by Northrop Grumman and ShieldEye to join the competition for the Future Tactical Drone System, in search of an alternative to the RQ-7B Shadow Tactical Drone. To understand the U.S. Army's decision, we first need to introduce the RQ-7 Shadow Drone. In 2008, the U.S. Marine Corps established the Shadow Drone Squadron specifically for this drone, showing its importance to the U.S. military. The RQ-7 is a lightweight reconnaissance drone developed and equipped by the U.S. military. With a length of 3.7 meters and a wingspan of 4.2 meters, it can detect targets within a range of 125 kilometers and conduct full-time reconnaissance of ground tactical vehicles within a 3.5 kilometer slant distance at high altitude. Since it was put into service in 2004, it has made an indelible contribution to the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan and is known as the Army's Eye. Its small size and lightweight make it flexible and ready for deployment at any time. Its main payload is a POP-300 insertable optical system consisting of a forward-looking infrared camera and a television camera, which can well meet the U.S. military's operational requirements for tactical-level drones. However, its disadvantages are also obvious, such as excessive noise and difficulty in carrying. Although it can be transported by a C-130 transport aircraft, a complete four-drone shadow package, including aircraft, high-maneuverial vehicles, hydraulic launchers, ground data control terminals, etc., requires three C-130s to transport. In order to address the disadvantages of the RQ-7 Shadow Drone, the U.S. military urgently needs a lightweight tactical-level drone that can replace it. The VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone developed by Northrop Grumman and ShieldEye. The VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone is only 2.7 meters long and has a wingspan of less than 3 meters. This machine combines the advantages of vertical takeoff and landing and the efficiency of fixed-wing aircraft. It can take off or land in an area of 9 square meters without being affected by the lack of special infrastructure, making it particularly suitable for crowded urban environments, areas with poor terrain, or the decks of watercraft. Additionally, the VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone can be transported by a pickup truck or a UH-60 helicopter, and its weight is only 60 kilograms. The drone can be started and operated by two people in less than half an hour. Its user interface based on a laptop computer gives it excellent portability. The VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone is equipped with a 183cc two-stroke engine, allowing it to reach a maximum speed of 160 kilometers per hour. Its flight altitude can reach 6,100 meters, with a flight time of up to 11 hours and a maximum payload capacity of 10 kilograms. It is very suitable for carrying various sensor systems, electronic intelligence devices, radar systems, electronic warfare suites, and communication equipment. VBAT's true modular nature makes it useful for cluster operations, as different drones can be equipped with different payloads, giving the entire cluster the flexibility to perform multiple tasks and quickly reconfigure. At the same time, ShieldEye's VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone integrates the HiveMind Eye system, which can still be used even when GPS and communication models are interfered with by the opponent. It can also eliminate the need for operators, GPS, and communication links. The data link provides the VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone with a communication distance of approximately 80 kilometers. Although this is largely affected by the terrain, its range can be expanded through a forward ground control station or by relaying with other aircraft. When the machine operates in fully autonomous mode, these data links will not be a limiting factor and will allow the machine to fly farther. The VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone can even be connected to the operator through a basic low-bandwidth satellite data link to provide simple monitoring updates and receive simple commands. Competition between the two drones requires more detailed comparisons and evaluations. But overall, the VBAT Vertical Takeoff and Landing Drone has a smaller size, higher efficiency, more convenient portability, and a wider range of applications, making it highly potential in the competition for future tactical drone systems.